So I finished the reaction, and I just want to say music is universal. Music translates into any language whatsoever. It does not matter if you understand the words, you understand the music. It is that fluent. So this is going to be a little bit different because I don't understand the lyrics at all. I did my best to look them up, I did my best to prepare, but I couldn't find any translations. So this review, or reaction, is a lot more of a reflection than anything. So prepare for fewer breaks and more of a conversation at the end. That being said, I hope you enjoy. That's it. That's the stuff. I want everyone watching this to take in your own deep breath, absorb that positive energy from the universe, and smile, because it is a beautiful day. And you want to know why? We are about to enjoy some beautiful music together. Today, I am reacting. No, we are reacting to Cassper's Hlengiwe, and if I mispronounce that, I am really sorry. It is the opening song off of his Any Minute Now album, so it is going to be very interesting to see what tone he wanted us to go into this album feeling, what sort of emotions he wanted to evoke early on, and just the overall theme and sound that he wants us to carry through the rest of the album, because you want to make a statement with that opening song. And a statement doesn't necessarily mean you have to go out there and be harder or more energized than anyone. It just means you want to create a tone for your consumers to follow and to absorb as they go on this musical journey or reading journey. Now, I did look up the title before diving into this, just because I had no idea what it meant. And I found two results. I found one, a gospel singer who... Let's take a look at that. I have it pulled up right now. Yes. A gospel singer, Hlengiwe Malaba. And if I'm butchering every name right now, I am incredibly sorry. And then I also saw a definition, which is, it means redeemed or nursed. So I'm not entirely sure which direction it's going to go. I just felt like if it was a title of a song that I didn't understand the title of the song, I'd be missing out on something. So with that being said, let's dive in. As always, if you like this content, I should probably introduce myself first. My name is RK Gold. I'm an author and business consultant living down in New Orleans, Louisiana. If you like this content, please hit the like button, subscribe with the bell notification. You can follow me on social media at author RK Gold. That's at A-U-T-H-O-R, RK Gold on Twitter and Instagram. You can leave me your recommendations in the comments below my Discord or my DMs. If you want to support the channel, please check out Father in the Forest. It's available for pre-order now. It comes out November 17th. Come that time, it will be available in paperback and audiobook format. Well, hopefully audiobook format. But currently, it's only available for pre-order in ebook format. It's my middle grade fantasy about a young girl living in a fictional continent 8 years after a civil war that gave her a new country independence, and she is looking for her birth family that she never met while finding new family along the way. I always liked coming of age and found family tropes, so this book is full of them. If you want to support the channel and you don't want to buy a book, I completely understand. We're in the midst of a pandemic and some books just aren't everyone's cup of tea. The Gray and Gold podcast is 100% free. It's available for your consumption on your streaming platform of choice. I include the Spotify link in the description box and the comments of every video. So that's the Gray and Gold podcast. It's myself and my co-host, Graydon Square. Brilliant fucking rapper, by the way. Highly recommend you check out his work. Compton's Gathering is my favorite album by him, but highly recommend you check out Graydon Square's work. He's a very philosophical rapper. And we just talk about the universe. We have some interesting interviews on, some creatives, some thought leaders, some business professionals. We were all over the place with our interviews. We just like to bring everything back to the big questions of, like, why? So if you want to support the channel for free, Grangle Podcast, 100% free, please check that out. And as always, let's just keep enjoying great music together. All right, we got Cassper's Hlengiwe featuring Zola 7. Again, if I'm butchering that pronunciation, I'm very sorry, and let's dive in.
And your verse, this is for you, Mfana, from Zola's. Yes.
Actually, before we start singing, I just want to make one comment there, because I actually kind of like that, and it's important to point out. When I hear an artist do a dedication page, my mind immediately goes to a book. It's very popular among authors. Before you, I could almost see the album's dedication page right there. We turn the page, the audio in the background of the instrumental went up a little bit, and you can sort of tell we were about to dive into the story, dive into this album together. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
And your verse, this is for you, Mfana, from Zolist. Yes.
Hlengiwe, oyeke intoko. Ulimi lungephimisele
Is this him? I feel like, yeah, this is him. If that's him, I'm looking at Zola 7 real quick, just because. Okay, Zola 7. So this is Zola then, who's singing. Whoever is singing right now has, I really like their voice. I really like how gritty it is. I like the sort of power it is conveying right there. It does sort of feel like they are leading a prayer, and there is some sort of call and response that I'm just missing out on.
Hlengiwe, uyeking to go so ulimi lunge pimise helila.
So it looks like I'm not going to understand a single word on this track. So let's talk about what I do understand. The music, it's a very calm sound that's going in, very gentle keys that are sort of leading the way, creating almost a linear journey across it as we hear this cyclical call and chorus by the singer. And that being said, when I was looking it up, as y'all saw firsthand, I couldn't find anything. So please help me understand this song, y'all. I'm definitely getting some prayer vibes. I'm absolutely getting some gospel vibes. I feel like the decision of this was sitting us down in church. We, the listeners of the congregation, as we are preparing for a sermon. That's just the overall vibe I'm getting from this track so far. That just also goes down to the, listen to the, such a gentle instrumental that really takes a step back for the texture and the grittiness of this voice. I mean, like, a lot of back of the mouth sounds coming out of it. Interesting thoughts. Let's take a look real quick at the Any Minute Now track list. Because, so it starts off with, I should have added Cassper in there. Because it starts off with what feels like a moment of prayer for us. Then it goes into Whom It May Concern. Now that is one I actually reacted to. Then it goes into One of One, then it goes into Thoughts. So it starts off rather pensive. This album does. I like the fact it didn't go into something like Friday Night. After that, that would have been completely ruined the theme. So he's carrying over a certain amount of energy. I'd say the first five tracks, maybe first four tracks, before go. So To Whom It May Concern, I just want to pull up the lyrics for that real quick. Yeah, look at this. Let's take a look what this says. Cassper used the second track on his fifth studio album to address problems he has with the industry mates that he has since fallen off with. Uses a reflective tone throughout the track, and although he doesn't mention any names, he leaves you to speculate on who he may be talking about. That feels like the perfect follow-up to this intro right here, because this intro really does feel like he's about to get very introspective. It feels like he's about to tell us everything he's been through, the sort of life he's led, and almost offering up these stories as life lessons. You can tell based when you have something of this sort of tone, that something serious but with a positive ending is going to follow. The overall tone of the song was absolutely optimistic, but caution. It was almost like you could definitely tell whatever story we're about to hear is going to have a happy ending, but prepare yourself. And that's sort of my, the last time I sort of have heard a sound like this, it was going to synagogue and hearing the cantor lead us with prayers in Hebrew, which I would happily translate for y'all if you were hearing those. So please help me understand the song a little bit better. That being said, I have to do more just because I'm very intrigued by this album. You can tell that there was a lot of thought in this. And I like the way his mind works. I like the fact that he definitely pushes boundaries. I feel like he's someone who, if you called him a rapper, he would say, "I'm not just that." Like he definitely, I don't need to share my screen anymore. You can tell he's making music for a purpose. You can tell that this is all, it all serves a purpose. It's all deliberate. He is doing this for a specific reason. It could be therapeutic. It could be a cautionary tale. It could be any number of things, but you could tell it's not just music for the sake of music, which I appreciate. I want to dive deeper into. That being said, this wasn't much of a reaction, but it was a bit of a reflection. So I hope y'all enjoyed it. I'm sorry if you didn't, and let's just keep enjoying great music together.